Hello developers, welcome to this video where we will be discussing the difference between the transfer and transfer from function in the context of smart contract development. When working with cryptocurrencies or any kind of digital asset on blockchain, it is important to understand that these assets are transferred from one account to another account and also from one contract address to account and vice versa. The transfer function is a standard function that mostly found in the ERC contract and is an important function. So the purpose of transfer function is to transfer the tokens from one address to another specified address. On the other hand, transfer from function is a more complex function. It allows a designated account to transfer tokens on behalf of the user. This designated account is often referred to as approved spender. The transfer from function is typically used in a situation like where there are multiple parties involved in a transaction. So suppose I want to exchange token on a decentralized exchange, then I have to use this transfer from function. Remember the thing that in order to use the transfer from function, it is necessary that you have to use the approved spender. So basically, firstly, this approved spender is authorized by the user through the approve function that you are allowed to use my funds. So this approve function allows the approved spender to transfer a specified amount of tokens on behalf of the user. Once the approval has been granted, the approved spender can call the transfer from function to transfer the tokens from the user address to another specified address. I guess we have talked enough, and it would be little difficult for you to understand this transfer and transfer from with definitions and all. So now we will be seeing the practical use case in coding, and you will clearly distinguish transfer from transfer from. So here you can see my remix code is open. I have deployed, let's not deploy it yet. So I have created two contracts. One is simple contract, that is ELD token. It's a basic creation of call token, nothing else. And another one is a staking contract. So we will be using this gold token in this staking contract. We will stake this gold token through this staking contract. That's usually the process occurring in blockchain. Whenever company launches its coin or something, then the next stage will be staking. You have to allow the staking. So in this way you will stake the coin, but we are not gonna dig deep into staking. We will just see the difference between the transfer and transfer from. So let's start. Let me explain a little bit about the staking contract. I hope you know the creation of ERC20. If you don't know, watch other videos or explore it on the internet. So first, I give assign a token variable, EIERC20, and then this is a mapping address, which will store the value of amount the user has staked. And then we have a constructor there. I am setting the token variable to this address. And then I have two functions. One is transfer function and stake transfer from and stake transfer. As the name state, stake transfer from, here we are using transfer from method, and in stake transfer we will be using transfer function. And with this, I will be trying to prove the point, the difference between these two functions. So let's begin. This is my first address. and here I will be deploy this GLD token with some initial value. Okay, and if you see the total supply, it is this much, I guess 9 to 10 euros. Okay, and if you see the balance of owner, then okay, every token is allocated to the owner. So what will I be doing is I will create staking contract and I will address this. I will paste this address. So now we have this staking contract, and if you see the value, we have no zero coin because we haven't staked anything, and balance of the contract is also zero. That's clear. So what will we be doing, we will be try to use stake transfer function to stake some money in this address. This is a contract address, so we'll be trying to stake in this address in the contract. Okay, so this is my address. Okay, so I am a user, I am trying to stake this address. Suppose I want, let's see, it will throw an error. It is saying that ERC20 transfer amount exceed balance. This is an error when you are trying to send some tokens more than the available in your wallet. But how is it possible? We are trying to send only 1 lakh tokens, but we have already how many? I guess more than 1 lakh, right? So why is this not happening? The basic thing is, simple thing is, in when you are trying to use the transfer function in another contract, like you are using the transfer function of this contract in another contract, in staking contract. So here the message or sender is not the address who is calling the transaction function. Message or sender here is a contract. This contract address means so transfer function takes two value, two and wallet amount, and it is calling the function token this transfer function not from the user perspective but from the contract perspective. So when the transfer function will be called from here, it will show that message.sender is this contract, but our contract has zero balance. As I can show you, it has zero balance. So that's why it is throwing an error. So when we use the transfer from function, it is important to remember that to use the transfer from function, we first have to use the approve function. It will allow the spender to spend your money. So I will be adding the spender. This is my spender, this contract, and the amount is how much? Let's use previous value. I approved it, and then I will be transferring this function. You see, now we were able to stake. If you check the balance, it will be updated. And if you check the balance of contract, it is updated. Okay, what if I try to use this stake transfer function right now? What will happen? What do you think? If you try to use this now, it is happening, but where will the fund go? The fund is, the transition happen basically here, the from whoever is sending the money, like I said that while using the token dot this this code we are using from contract address, and this address, which is our contract address. So we are sending the money from the contract to the contract, same contract. The balance will always will be same, and total will supply will also be same. Okay, I hope this is clear. If it is not clear, let me again show you this. So what I will be doing, I will address, and here using address, let me deploy the contract again. So here, first let me transfer some funds. I have approved it and will okay. So now our contract has some funds, 1 lakh tokens, and now if we use take transfer, I'll put the same amount and address. So I want to transfer some fund from my contract to this address. And it will happen. Why? Because the fund was in the contract, and this transfer function transfer the fund from here. What is from? From was contract address, but to is not contract address, because we are not using the address this, we are using the address of this. And so the transfer happened, and if you see the balance of the contract, it is zero. And you see the balance of this, it is showing. I hope this is clear. I hope this video has helped you to understand the difference between transfer and TransferFrom function in the smart contract development. I have learned it through the hard way, and I don't, if it is okay if you are learning through the hard way, it's okay, but sometimes we are totally stuck and we are not able to find the path. So in that case, if this video is helpful to you, I will be happy to know. Thanks for watching.